I've got 2016 versions of both the Bosch center drive and Yamaha electric bike drive systems here. One of the first things you'll notice is just the larger battery pack and larger charging unit for the Yamaha motor, but a slightly larger actual drive unit, while the other accessories and battery pack are a little bit smaller on Bosch, including the display panel. So let's just hit some specs real quick. These Bosch motors offer 250 to 350 watts peak output, 60 newton meters or 75 newton meters if you get this performance CX high torque version. By contrast, Yamaha offers 250 to 500 watts peak output with 80 newton meters of torque. You can't see it because I don't actually have the sprockets installed right now, but the Bosch drive units use these smaller sprockets with 16 teeth or 18 teeth versus the Yamaha drive system, which uses a more traditionally sized 38 tooth, at least as far as I've seen doing my reviews. So they're fairly comparable if you get the Performance CX high torque, but you're still getting a little bit more torque from the Yamaha drive unit. And they do perform differently. I'm gonna take them out to the trail and comment on that a little bit more later, but this is still just all about the specs. So let's hit the battery chargers real quick. This is a 2.2 amp charger from Bosch. Pretty light, only weighs 1.7 pounds, very compact, and you can even unplug the wall side so you can make it really, really small. Proprietary plug at this end. It's a nice little unit. What we're looking at here is a European Yamaha charger. Unfortunately, I don't have access to a US version, but they share a lot of similarities. So I'm just gonna touch on this. 4 amps output, 2 pounds, so it's a little bit heavier than the Bosch unit, and it's definitely bigger. You can see that the wall side does not unplug. So if this were the US version, it would be very similar, but maybe not quite as tall. You can see it has a proprietary plug at the end, and this is kind of a unique plug because it actually slides. So it connects right on this little, kind of under this rubber nipple. It's much smaller, whereas the Bosch is a little bit heftier, a little bit tougher looking. Both of these batteries can be charged on or off the bike. You don't need to take them off. They both lock, which is nice. The Yamaha battery pack, it doesn't have any metal reinforcement or anything. It just kind of has that little plastic notch and it slides in from the side versus Bosch, which kind of pivots in like that. And it does have a little bit of a metal lip, so it seems a bit more secure to me. The Yamaha and Bosch batteries offer the exact same watt hours, 36 volt, 11 amp hours for 396 watt hours total. They both sort of round and say, hey, Powerpack 400. So it's slightly less than 400, but you know, it's very close. The Yamaha pack weighs 6.5 pounds, whereas the Bosch pack slightly lighter, 5.3 pounds. So when you add the motors and the batteries up, they both weigh exactly 14.1 pounds. And I weighed these myself. I was really surprised. You know, I was thinking, man, that motor 8.8 pounds versus 7.6. I mean, Yamaha has the edge, but then you look at their battery pack and it's slightly heavier at 6.5 pounds versus 5.3. So that was just really interesting to me. Of course, you can take the batteries off. So you get a bit of an edge with the Yamaha system if you take the battery off and you're lifting it onto your car, or a bike rack or something. It's gonna save a little bit of weight. Both of these have removable display panels, like you can see here. Grayscale, backlit, lots of viewing area, and I think this one goes to Yamaha. It's slightly larger. They both have independent batteries, so you can use them while they're off the bike, and this one even has like a little hole for adding a leash. You could put it on a keychain or something so you wouldn't lose it. That's kind of nice. I have heard from some of the hardcore mountain bikers that if you crash an electric bike and it goes tumbling, you know, those display panels can kind of get, you know, banged up. So having something that's a little bit slimmer isn't such a bad thing. The Bosch does have 4 buttons on it, as well as an external button pad with 3 buttons, whereas the Yamaha display panel does not have any buttons on the display unit, and it has, I think, 6 on the button pad. Also on the button pad, which is located near the left grip, you've got a little micro USB port, whereas the Bosch unit has the micro USB built right into the display, and that can be used for maybe charging your phone if you're using it as a GPS unit or listening to some music. Again, both of them backlit, and this one has the light right on it. Both of these drive units are pretty advanced. They're measuring wheel speed, cadence, and pedaling torque. And the Bosch system claims to do that 1,000 times per second. In my experience, it's very, very responsive, and that front sprocket spins at a higher RPM consistently. So you do hear it, it's a little bit more pronounced, kind of a whing. Whereas Yamaha's slow, steady, and a little bit more power, but it doesn't have that range of support. So I've noticed when I shift gears down, it feels like I'm getting less power until my cadence slows, in which point the Yamaha system kicks back in. So it's always difficult to try to explain that to people without showing it. So let's go out there, let's hit the trail. I'm gonna ride with both. So let's talk about starting this thing up. How does that work? Well, first of all, we've got a display panel right in the middle, nice big screen. It pivots so you can reduce glare. And then we've got a breakout button pad over here on the side with kind of everything you need. So you can really be holding on with these locking grips, handling yourself on the bike really well, but kind of have this intuitive, like, oh, I need more support. Click, click, arrowing up, or, oh, I need less, I'm going downhill, I want to save the battery, get a better workout, whatever, click down. So I love that there's a little bit of tactile feedback built in. But jumping into the display itself, the first thing you see is your speed. Right now it's in miles per hour. I could reset that if I want by holding reset and I at the same time. And then it goes into configuration. And then you just press I again, so we could set the clock, the wheel circumference, language, I'm in English right now, units, kilometers per hour versus miles per hour, time format, 24-hour shift recommendation. This is a new thing. So as you're pedaling, if your RPM, your pedal cadence gets higher and higher, there's these little arrows that appear that say, hey, shift up. So, if you're a really good cyclist, you don't need that. You could turn it off if you want, but it's a neat little feature for 2016 that they added. Power on, display version, just a bunch of other information. To get out of this, we'll hold reset and I again for a couple seconds. This display is backlit. Can't see it because it's super bright out right now, but that's kind of cool. Just a faint glow makes it easy to read. So we talked about speed. We've got our battery up there. It's got 5 bars to give you some general idea of how full it is. And then if we press I here or over here, we're gonna cycle through the different other menus. So right now we've got trip distance, clock, maximum speed, average speed, trip time, and range. Range is really cool. It dynamically senses like how much battery capacity is remaining and then what level of assist are we in. And as you change assist level, it's gonna give you some estimate for how far it thinks you can go. So right now we'll go to the lowest level of assist, eco. The pack is fully charged right now and it's saying, hey, 76 miles. And then as you go a little bit higher, tour, our range drops way down to almost 40 miles, sport, 29, and turbo, 24. Like, here's the button pad I was talking about. So 4 buttons on the front, 1 on top for power, and 1 for walk mode on the bottom. And then right down here, that's where the little micro USB is. Probably can't see it too well here, but yeah, it's nice that it has that. Really big, easy to read. I think the speed, miles per hour, is very similar in size to the Bosch Intuvia display, but you get like your power meter over here and just a little bit more space for those other readouts. 10 bars on a battery level. We've got odometer, and if we press the S button over there, you can see there's the odometer, distance, battery percentage, as well as those bars, so that's kind of nice. And then rotations per minute, and average speed, and max speed, and there's tons of information here, clock and trip time, and then this power meter that goes up and down depending on how much power the motor's actually putting out. So you can kind of get an idea as you're riding, like, oh, how hard is the motor working, and therefore, how quickly am I using that battery capacity. So I like that. And then there are really 4 levels of assist to choose from. So if we click up here, we go from no assist, where it's just like a mountain bike, to eco plus, to eco, to standard, to high. And so it's really like there's these 3 different names, and I feel like they just added eco plus because maybe they didn't have room on the display. Now plus just gives you an even lower level. The other thing I like about the display is that you can adjust the angle right here, and it does have these little
these kind of teeth. So once you've got that set, it sort of sticks, but then the whole thing actually kind of swivels on the bar if you don't over tighten it. So very similar again to the Intuvia system. Actually very pleased with this. It's large, it's right where you want it, looking straight down, very nice. And then the button pad's easy to reach while you're riding, so you don't have to look down. You can even kind of just get used to it. You can feel a little click and you can tell that you're getting more power. Out at 17 because I'm not in the highest gear. Just going a little slower. And there we go. I'm basically, the motor has got me up to like that 10 mile per hour mark, and then it just backs off because it's just got that limited RPM. So on the Bosch powered high bike, I was cruising through this section a lot faster. Okay, onto the really steep section. This is where I switched to gear one with the Bosch. Try to stay seated the whole way. Struggling a little bit. This is where Bosch started to struggle too. It's a similar experience. I'm just spinning a lot slower. The motor's doing most of the work. And that's the RPM thing that I was kind of mentioning before. Bosch just seems to have more power at higher RPMs. Woo! Oh yeah. I think I got more of a cardio workout with Bosch. I wasn't pedaling as fast with Yamaha, but I got similar good power support in that last stretch. Just felt like I was right, you know, just getting that little push in the lowest gear in both of them. Pretty great experience.
I've been curious about these drive systems for a long time. You know, we've been hearing about Yamaha entering the United States, offering electric bikes, including high bikes, that are almost $1,000 cheaper than Bosch. So you wonder, like, well, is it worth the extra $1,000 to go with a Bosch drive unit? You know, what are the differences? I hope this has helped you to come to some conclusions. People who want to be more active and pedal and feel like they're moving the bike, I think the Yamaha system is actually good for that. Whereas Bosch, it's always there for you. It's very responsive and it activates and deactivates extremely quickly. It also has shift sensing, which the Yamaha system does not. So this one might produce less wear on your drivetrain. Whereas you're going to be required to shift and you're going to be a little bit more sensitive when you're shifting on Yamaha. And because it relies a little more heavily on torque versus torque and cadence, I find that it doesn't mash the gears quite as much as some of the lower end drive systems. For more electric bike reviews and information like this, I'll see you back at the website, ElectricBikeReview.com. I've also got a forum where you can kind of chat and exchange ideas. If you have ideas for other guides like this, feel free to sound off in the comments, or if you want to make a correction or provide any feedback, and hopefully I'll be able to do this again in the future.